In this demo, you'll see how SolidWorks 2025 boosts your productivity by improving cosmetic thread performance for parts with a large number of shaded threads. Gives you more flexibility, allowing you to choose Y-up or Z-up orientations. Helps you quickly select multiple edges when creating chamfers. And helps you quickly create simplified representations of your parts with Silhouette D feature. SolidWorks 2025 also helps you improve your parts performance by revealing graphics triangles and face count, create smooth, continuously blended variable size fillets, delete complex or broken features below the rollback bar, streamline difficult workflows like measurement of a projected area, and repair dangling sketch entities lightning fast. Let's discuss what's new in SolidWorks 2025 for part modeling. Our goal with this assembly is to create a simplified representation of it, either for replacing it in a parent assembly or maybe to send out for quoting while protecting intellectual property. However, there are some operations that we need to do in the part environment, so we'll need to create a multi-body part from this assembly. First, in SolidWorks 2025, you'll see a huge performance improvement in components with many cosmetic threads. Opening the file, rebuilding, creating features, editing features and more. You'll notice that this assembly is in the Y-up orientation, but our vendor has asked for it in Z-up. Since we are converting this assembly to a multi-body part, which was introduced last year in 2024, we are prompted to select a part template. Now in SolidWorks 2025, you can select either Y-up or Z-up orientations when creating both parts and assemblies. Let's quickly add a few chamfers here. SolidWorks 2025 makes adding chamfers a breeze with the Selection Accelerator toolbar. Similarly to fillets, you can now select multiple edges very quickly. This part is missing a groove bead weld. SolidWorks 2025 introduces a new type of weld that effortlessly fills the gap. We'll discuss this more in the weldments demo. Our part is finalized and ready to be simplified. In the past, we had a single D feature method. But now we have a new option for silhouette geometry, where we can create simplified models based on the outline of the bodies. Each simplification method adjusts the overall part detail: cylindrical, polygon outline, tight fit outline, and now an option to keep internal loops such as holes. Silhouette defeature offers two output methods. To send our part to a vendor for quoting, save as a new document would be best. And to replace the component in an assembly as a simplified version, create a new configuration would be best. The next multi-body part needs some finishing touches. In SolidWorks 2025, improving a part's performance is easy now that we have graphic triangle count and face count. Graphics triangle count effectively tells us how complex the part is and how difficult it is to render. Face count reports the number of faces, which also affects performance as well as file size. This part has over 26,000 triangles, which means that curved faces appear very smooth, but also means that panning, zooming, and rotating could be slow and therefore reduce our productivity. We can easily reduce the impact by adjusting this slider in the document properties. Notice that we've reduced the triangle count from about 26,000 to around 9,000. Faces with tight curvature are a common culprit. This variable fillet seems pinched. No problem, SolidWorks 2025 introduces the continuous edge blend option for variable sized fillets. This creates a smooth, continuously blended face which will reduce triangle and face count. Before finalizing our performance evaluation, we can see that a sketch pattern has a high rebuild percentage. Sometimes moving the rollback bar below these items will require all of our computer resources, but this cut sweep may give us a hint. Someone has cut threads in the sheet metal body, which is not a best practice. Patterning these features makes the computation problem much worse. Fortunately, in SolidWorks 2025, deleting features below the rollback bar is as simple as a right mouse click. This body is planned for injection molding. To roughly quote a cost, a projection onto a plane normal to the pull direction is needed. SolidWorks 2025 makes this easy. Simply select the body or face and the projected plan to find your area. This part is almost complete. However, moving the rollback bar reveals a sketch error. Editing the sketch, we can see that this 2mm dimension has lost its reference and is dangling. Reattaching it to the new reference is easy with this red drag handle. However, SolidWorks 2025 makes this even easier with an automatic repair tool. It can be accessed in the right-click menu or by opening the Display Delete Relations property pane. There are options to automatically find a replacement, or simply click Repair All Dangling. Very handy if you have a lot of dangling relations. Let's now discuss some of the enhancements that we weren't able to show in the demonstration. In SolidWorks 2025, we can now automatically convert meshes to standard B-Rep bodies, a much more superior and more compatible type. SolidWorks can now import 3MF beam lattices as parasolid lattices, graphics mesh, or wireframes. SolidWorks 2025 can create linear or circular patterns of reference geometry, and Move Copy Bodies has now been enhanced to allow equations, configurations, and dimension flipping. And finally, Curve Through XYZ Points now gives us an option to start at a user-defined coordinate system. We can convert entities as construction geometry, saving multiple button clicks. Now, there are always many more enhancements every year in the new release. That's no different for parts, so make sure you check out the What's New documentation for a full list.